thanks for coming for us tonight.
Cool.
All right. So I'm going to start off with my first question. I heard you got a degree in music and engineering and stuff like that.
That's true, yeah.
So when you took those courses, were you original goal to be a producer, just a producer or a management? Or what was your main goal?
I already was into music as a producer. I've been doing this for like 10 years. Well, I wanted to get like a degree attached to it, and I wanted to do that at a school that, you know, is renowned for producing so much like great talents like Quincy Jones. So I went to Berkeley, and that's the reason why I went there, to add to what I have, you know, and also the business side, because I do all my productions, I also produce other artists, and, you know, I have a label name to myself, which I plan to like get other artists on the, you know, so that's pretty much was the drive of trying to produce my get my music produced. I was too young at that time, my parents didn't support me, so I couldn't afford like a session in the studio.
So I had
to sneak my way into the studio as a keyboardist.
Right.
And from there learned, you know, the whole ropes, climb the ladders and then, you know.
So you don't have to depend on no one else's production. Right, excellent. So you said that this album is more personal for you.
Well, yeah. My second album. My first album was released back in 2006. It was more, because I started as a rock artist. My genre was pretty much like rock music, pop, the likes of Bon Jovi, U2, Coldplay, that kind of thing I did. Which is targeted to mostly my UK-based audience and the US-based audience. This time around, I want to get my roots as Nigerian, and I want to bring it down to the level that people in Nigeria has got to understand and relate to. Also, not lose my quality, and also not, you know, lose my UK and US based fans. So I had to play neutral, make a lot, you know, make it, you know, pop, get a blend of something that's going to go well with like the Nigerian community. And the album, you know, I use mistakes from the first album to help me. November this year, but some of the singles were already out on you know, on radio, online, all that.
So speaking of your influences, Lenny Kravitz, such as you have Bon Jovi as well, I'm not sure. That's a different variety of music, you know what I mean? So how did you work around, you know, your music?
I produced a jazz album, I produced a classical album, I produced an R&B album, I produced a rock album, I produce anything, I'm that versatile. So I can go from a Marvin Gaye to a Lil Jon. So, you know, to Bob Marley, which is pretty much my album. My album, you can't really give it a genre because you have rock in it, you got R&B in it, you got blues in it, you got pop music, you got hip hop.
So you're aiming every
reggae.
Everything.
My album is just to entertain.
That's
just to show how versatile I am as a musician and to cut across different genres and different walks of life, different fans from kids 3 years old to adults 80 years old. That's my music. For
well, it's important. You want to get everyone.
First, I didn't have the funds at that time. I basically produced, just like I produced this album, I produced it myself. I didn't have the marketing skills to push it on my own. I didn't have the right PR. I didn't have the right management. It was just basically just me. And that kind of, it was a good album. I have so many good songs. The album is now on iTunes. For people who want to go back in time to see what Duncan Daniels was all about before.
Give your details.
Just type Duncan Daniels in iTunes, the album title is I Don't Tire. It comes up, you know, in iTunes. And when this new album called Showstopper comes out, it's also going to be on iTunes. You can get it on iTunes as well.
Okay, awesome. So being an international artist and having the opportunity to do music in a broader spectrum, when you're
www.reverbnation.com/DunkinSHROCK. It's DunkinSHROCK. What?